Okay, one second. Facebook seems to be having a small challenge here. So, Facebook seems to be having a challenge taking the live at the moment. But it also says we're streaming to Facebook. So, okay, so I guess we'll get going. All right, welcome everyone. We are so glad you could join us today for the District Performance Redesign, Sustainability, and Growth community conversation. And today we have our superintendent, Shauna Murphy, here to get us started.
Thank you, Rob. I definitely appreciate that introduction. Good day, everyone. And I am excited to share with you a presentation regarding the future of Cincinnati Public Schools. So I am ready, Rob, whenever you are with the slide presentation. All right, community. So today's presentation will be about Cincinnati Public Schools district performance, redesign, sustainability, and growth. And this conversation will begin with phase one, which started June 2024, and we expect to run through September 2024. Next slide. So phase 1A is a focus on Spencer Center for Gifted and Exceptional Students and Riverview East Academy. Next slide. We took a look after talking to the LSDMC and reading reports and surveys that had been done by Spencer Center for Gifted and Exceptional Students. And we took a look at some of their strengths, considered weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. And some of the strengths, as you can see, include their guiding principles, the outcomes they have for students, their methods, practices, structures, systems, and their learning environment. Some of the weaknesses they noted include the science laboratories, visual arts classrooms, their cafeteria space, their gymnasium space. Some opportunities, more outside and informal spaces, growth and enrollment, community readiness, and then threats. Their students have been known to leave the school after grades 4 and 8, and the facility that they have. Next slide, please. Riverview East Academy, we also looked at strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. And some of the strengths include that the school K-12 was envisioned for the students of the East End. And we noticed a strength being their health career focus. Right now, the school has a total K-12 enrollment of 482 students, with 92 students living within those school boundaries. The opportunity at Riverview East Academy is the building capacity of 800 students, but some of the threats include enrollment and the cost of transportation. Next slide, please. This map will show you by grade level the different areas of the city for which Riverview East students live. As you can see, Riverview East does a draw from across the city, neighboring many, many, many neighborhoods. Next slide, please. This slide shows the enrollment at Riverview East Academy by grade level. So you'll see to the far right, the enrollment is a total of 482 students. You'll see just underneath that 482 in boundary students, total 92 students. And you can see the breakdown by grade level. There are 14 preschool students, K-6, 117, 7-8, 106, and 9-12, 245. At Mount Washington School, we'll share at this point, their total enrollment is 287. And you can see pre-K to 6, the number of students they have for each grade level. Next slide, please. The recommendation that was presented to the Board of Education 2 weeks ago include relocating the K-6 students of Riverview East to Mount Washington School, relocating the 7th and 12th grade Riverview East students to the second floor of Riverview East Academy, and relocating the 7th to 12th grade students to the neighborhood or school of their choice for fiscal year 25 or fiscal year 26. Regarding Spencer Center, the recommendation is to relocate Spencer Center to the first floor of Riverview East Academy for the fiscal year 25, and then they would then occupy the entire space for fiscal year 26. Next slide, please. This slide shows the space that the schools say they need on the left-hand side and the space that is available on the right-hand side. The team took into account all of the courses that were needed and walked the building multiple times to identify classroom space that would be available. Next slide, please. Additional recollections, relocations include pre-K disability and pre-K co-taught classrooms moving to Bramble, relocating five autistic strides units. The locations are still being evaluated and discussions are being prepared to be held with the principals of other buildings, but we do know that we can relocate those units as a whole to other locations. Next slide. Next slide, please. Thank you. Phase 1B includes the Promise Center and the Dr. Odell Owen Center for Learning. Next slide. The average daily attendance for students at the Promise Center includes 201 students. For the Dr. Odell Owen Center for Learning, the enrollment is 47 students. There's a recommendation to relocate the Promise Center and the Dr. Odell Owen Center for Learning to the current Spencer Center building. Next slide, please. The Dr. Odell Center for Learning enrollment, you can see again the total 49, the breakdown by grade level, and then the grade span, 7 and 8, there are 9 students, and 9 to 12, there are 40 students, again, for a total of 49 students at this school. Next slide, please. Phase 1C, the Dr. Odell Owen Center for Learning building would then become a partnership with Schroeder High School. Next slide, please. The Dr. Odell Center for Learning building would be repurposed as a building to host our first CPS middle school. Schroeder High School, 7th and 8th grade students, would then relocate to the new building to be named by the Board of Education, the CPS Middle School building. Next slide, please. The timeline for this work, next slide. So there was a Spencer Center parent gathering where there were a couple of board members coming to that meeting and had informal conversations during that time. On this coming Friday, June the 28th, there is Riverview East Academy LSDMC meeting scheduled. That meeting is for 9 a.m. and we're in the process of scheduling the faculty and the staff meeting. On an ongoing basis, we are planning a kickoff for parent conversation, stakeholder conversation, focus groups that will result in the synthesis, analysis, and presentation. This slide says establishing the meeting for Schroeder LSDMC, but that will take place tonight at 5 o'clock. And there is a LSDMC meeting for the Dr. Odell Owen Center Friday at 11 o'clock. Next slide, please. Here is the phase one timeline. Again, as we mentioned, the schools involved in phase one, Spencer Center for Gifted and Exceptional Students, Riverview East Academy, Promise Center, the Dr. Odell Owen Center for Learning, and Schroeder Middle School. Again, these conversations began June 2024, and will continue the phase in through September 2024. Next slide, please. We are in the phase of having town halls, focus groups, caregiver surveys, and board conversation. Again, starting September 2024 through December 2024 for the phase two timeline. Next slide, please. And this slide is rather detailed. You can see for the next three fiscal years, fiscal year 25, 26, 27, the planning and then the implementation. So beginning August 2024, you see the implementation of looking at the Zoo Academy, currently hosted and supported by Hughes STEM High School for fiscal year 25. We will begin conversation and planning for an early college program on the west side, an international baccalaureate program on the east side, Public Safety Academy focusing in on security and 911. Our MLL Resource Center, it's in parentheses as a perhaps, but we definitely want to begin to create that resource center for our English language learners, our multi-language learners. A CTE Career and Technical Education Center that is centralized. A Montessori Middle School at Hughes Annex. We're looking at the feeder patterns into our high schools. We're looking at creating a system of healthy environments. For implementation during fiscal year 26, we will have in place the early college on the west side, International Baccalaureate on the east, Public Safety Academy, the MLL Resource Center, feeder pattern redesign, creating a system of a healthy enrollment. Planning will begin then for the Career and Technical Education Center being centralized, the Montessori Middle School at Hughes Annex. And then we see implemented fiscal year 27, that Career and Technical Education Center, including an automotive program, cosmetology, and entrepreneurship program. The Montessori Middle School at Hughes Annex would then open. Next slide, please. Before we open for questions, we are also looking at that previous slide. Rob, if I could ask you, please go back one. The blue ribbon at the bottom takes a look at some of those feeder patterns where there can be an elementary, a middle school, and a high school feeder. It also takes a look at some of our smaller schools in terms of enrollment and having those conversations and engagements about what we can do with the smaller schools so that we can have healthy environments for those schools in terms of the number of students attending. All right, next slide, please. All right, so I believe at this time we're going to open this up for question and answer.
Thank you, Superintendent. Well, it's really exciting. We are definitely getting questions, so people are excited. We have around 100 people watching on the Zoom. So thank you, everyone, first for joining us. We appreciate that. So we are going to go ahead and just start jumping right into the questions, Superintendent, if you're okay with that.
I am great with that. Thank you so much.
All right. No, thank you. And thank you for everyone joining us. The first one. Does the enrollment level slide include the autism units at Riverview East? So that heat map that we have, did that include students in the autism units as well in the heat map?
In the heat map, it includes all of the students who attend Riverview East Academy. Yes.
Perfect. That was a good one to start with.
Appreciate it.
Is the special education department involved in the relocation of the autism units? Have they weighed in on the appropriateness of the short runway to relocate student populations?
The Student Services Department is included in conversations on the best locations for the autism units. They are on board with this plan. Yes. Thank you for that question.
Fantastic. Thank you. And like I said, we have them coming in. Yes. Curious about how space will work that might need to be shared. So I'm guessing this is Riverview, gym, the front desk, especially cafeteria. I'm also wondering about playground equipment for 3 to 6 Spencer kids in the transition for next year.
Sure, thank you for that question. Yes, the principals are working together or will work together on their master scheduling and how shared spaces, the cafeteria, the gymnasium will be utilized. We have had possible conversations about whether or not we would have the specials be on a semester basis, where, for example, the Riverview East students would have gym the first semester and the Spencer students would have it the second semester, just for this one year.
Thank you very much for that. We also have a question about providing the slideshow we just had. So I've talked to Catherine. We will add the slideshow and this video when we're finished to a web page, so that way the public has access to it after this meeting as well, just as a follow-up. How can we be discussing the plan that will be implemented in less than 2 months with the UA units locations not determined? It sends a message to parents of autistic students that these students are not a priority. So.
Don't want to send a message that the students are not a priority. They're very much a priority and have been specifically called out in these conversations and want to include the parents to every extent possible. This is the first of a couple of these sessions, as well as some in-person sessions, the first of a survey that is coming out where all of the families who could be and will be impacted will have the opportunity to be engaged.
Thank you very much for that, Superintendent. I appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
How does the enrollment slide, we've covered that. There's also a question about being able to see the Spencer kids heat map, where they're located. I know we don't have that at the moment for this slide, but there seems to be some interest for that as well, and where Spencer's students are coming from.
Perhaps we can add that after we perhaps post this slide. Want to make sure everyone understands the difference with Spencer being a magnet program with a testing component for enrollment, and they do draw at the high school level from all over the city.
Thank you very much for that, Superintendent. I'm curious, is there a reason Spencer is moving, and was the building doesn't meet high school needs? I'm guessing they're talking about Riverview, is being considered for the building. So I guess we're asking why Spencer is moving, really.
So on the slides we shared, Spencer needs a high school gym, regulation gym. They also need science laboratories and other things that would meet their needs as a 3 through 12 building.
Thank you very much. Superintendent, what is the cost benefit for doing this? If it was delayed a year to help make it a smoother transition, how would that affect the outcome?
So we are in a budget crisis at this point, and a budget crisis requires us to act swiftly in an informed way, but it is critically important. And please remember, this is a plan that is developed over a 3-year period of time. It's not focused solely on one or two individual schools, but will impact the growth, the sustainability of our district, the financial health of our district over a period of time.
Thank you very much for that, Superintendent. I appreciate it. All right, our next question is about Schroeder High School. How do the distance at the current Schroeder High School be supported when separated from the rest of the deaf units? Are there plans to add teachers of the deaf to the new school as well as a resource room? How many deaf 7th and 8th grade students are there?
I don't have the number of deaf middle school 7th and 8th grade students, but we can find out for sure. There is no plan to disrupt the classrooms that they have as 7th and 8th grade students from Schroeder. As a matter of fact, we believe that there will be greater services with there being a 7th and 8th grade school for those students. And you will see in the presentation, the goal would be to have over time, over the 3-year period of time, a 7th and 8th grade site on the east side, the west side, and centralized.
Thank you very much, Superintendent. We appreciate it. Will the AU faculty be transferred as well? The autism unit faculty be transferred as well to the new school?
The plan is to keep all of the units intact with their teachers. Yes.
And again, these are community questions.
Yes.
There is concern about, I think the stress or how we have we considered why we're doing this to the students? Are you thinking of what you're doing to the students' education? These students cannot be thrown into another school. Some of these students have been to school since it has been opened. Do you want to address a little bit of the concern about that transition for our students?
Absolutely. I totally understand concerns about the students. We want to put the kids first, and we believe by making these moves and creating this plan will help us have the best students and the best opportunities for those students. We do believe and we do know that the supports will be in place for all of our kids. We believe that all of our schools are welcoming environments and that our children will thrive in buildings, no matter where they are in our school district.
Thank you, Superintendent. I apologize for the delay as I'm trying to get questions together here. We have a
Yes,
lot of
sir.
great questions and wonderful people participating. We really do appreciate that. All right. Why does it seem like we're only focused on Spencer Center? What about the families of Riverview? We feel they're being ignored.
So it's not that we're just focusing on Spencer and we're not just focusing on Riverview. They just happen to be in phase one of the plan. Again, this is a 3-year plan over time that will impact the health of the growth and sustainability of the entire district.
Thank you very much, Superintendent. Would you mind explaining the healthy enrollment strategy? More of the similar schools. If the enrollment does not increase, will schools be consolidated or other schools? I think we've talked a little bit about the timeline for some of that, but
Yeah, so a part of the conversation are the smaller schools. There will be conversations around whether or not consolidation is the best answer. We're not there yet for some of those smaller schools, but it is really challenging to be able to have a school with fewer than 300 students. The more students you have, quite frankly, that is how we're financed, then the more services you can provide for children.
Superintendent, thank you very much. We're speaking as if this is a done deal. In your mind, is this final? Is a question we have as well.
I
And
don't know that
Superintendent,
it. Yes, I'm sorry.
I'm going to pause you for just a minute before you answer that. Just to let you know, we have 30 new messages, everyone. We do want to take time to make sure we're only going to be going till 1 o'clock. So we're going to try to do our best to consolidate some of these questions, but we really appreciate everyone jumping in and being a part of this. So as we keep going, thank you, Superintendent.
Yes. Would you repeat the last question again, Rollo?
Yeah, I will. That was my fault. Sorry about that.
No.
We're speaking as if this is a done deal. In your mind, is this final? Is this a final decision?
This we are not at the final decision.
Right, that was an easy one. Will there be therapy available for all the children who are being pushed out or moved from Riverview School?
So all of our students, if it's a therapy, a mental health question, all of our schools have mental health partners in place.
Thank you. Will the strategy unit also move?
Yes.
That's the one at Schroeder. So,
Oh, Schroeder Strides Unit.
yes.
Is it a seventh and eighth grade Strides Unit? That will depend. We're talking only at
Gotcha.
Schroeder seventh and eighth grade students.
So, if they're in that grade band, they may move then. So,
That's correct.
okay. All right, we've asked about counseling services, and I think we've covered that a little bit. I'm gonna keep going here. The OL's center numbers are for this past year are about 70 enrolled for the upcoming school year, which do have IEP regulations. We can only have 10 students to one intervention specialist as it's run in the Stride units. We also have a waiting list. Are there any additional opportunities to grow the Owens Center in the current building? And I'll add as what about the new building?
The
So
proposal is for the new building, and I think that I know that there is even more space in the newer building. So the number I have as of last evening is the number on the slide. However, if they grow to 70, that building can accommodate very easily 70 students.
Thank you very much. When thinking about moving Schroeder's middle school, how would staff be moved, especially those staff who are intended to teach both middle and high school students? This potentially impacts the access to elective classes, affects semester scheduling and staffing for both potentially both buildings.
Yes, it definitely can affect and impact master scheduling in all of these buildings. That is certain. The principals, we've had conversations, they are fully aware of this. Any support around master scheduling that is needed will be provided. We have identified those who are really great and have a strong talent at master scheduling. Not concerned about that.
Thank you very much. Spencer Center's already had a parent gathering. There are questions on whether Riverview will have a parent gathering as well. Superintendent?
The principal is scheduling all of that. As I mentioned on a slide, we do have the LSDMC meeting scheduled for 9 a.m. Friday. We are working with the principal to have a parent and a staff meeting scheduled as well.
Thank you, Superintendent. Does the board have to vote on this moving forward?
I am not certain whether the board will vote on this or not. We are in consultation and working cooperatively with the board.
Thank you very much. Superintendent, do you believe this was led by a fiscal decision? And can you share budget? There are a number, Superintendent, of budget questions around this topic, and kind of like we talked about the why. There seems to be a lot of budget conversations about the skin. Can you kind of address that one more time? And we're going to start skipping over those questions as we address it here, if you don't mind.
Yeah, the budget is one aspect of this, that is for sure. I did mention we are in a budget crisis, and there are a lot of elements that play into the budget crisis. And then, in answering that, overall, the course of the 3-year plan, there will be items as it relates to the budget addressed. Specifically, if you look at that heat map for Riverview East, the transportation is challenging, and we do believe that that can help us relieve some of the budget as it relates to transporting our children.
Thank you very much, Superintendent.
Yes.
As the district prides itself on giving the best educational services to most of our vulnerable students, how do we justify prioritizing unique small groups of gifted students and families over the Riverview's more vulnerable students?
This plan is prioritizing every single child and every single seat at every single schoolhouse in this district. Every single school is being reviewed as a result of this work. We are simply starting with the Riverview East, Spencer, Odell Owens, Promise Center, Schroeder families.
Thank you, Superintendent. I know we're working through these questions, and there's a lot of really great questions here, and a lot of them are tough questions. And we know this will be a hard transition.
Thank you,
We have a
Rob. I
question about.
appreciate you processing all of the questions and trying to have some order. Thank you.
Of course, of course. We have some questions about students who are in the JFS system, foster students, students that are some of our most at-risk students who go to
Absolutely.
some of these schools that need to transition and
Yes.
need to communicate with. How are we addressing communicating with them those changes? And of course, the trauma and disturbance of change, and we've talked about that. But a plan moving forward to communicate with those students to make sure they find their location for the new school year.
Absolutely. One blessing, our district and board supported the creation of a customer care center many, many, many years ago. We have a strong relationship with Hamilton County Job and Family Services, and we have a whole customer care team on board who can support any family, whether they have a child who is in JFS custody or no.
Thank you. Thank you. We have a question about graduate Riverview and graduations. A number of questions about how that will work for students who are going to graduate from or are in high school, not Riverview, and in the transition, what that looks like. So if
Whether
I'm a ninth
I'm
grade
sorry.
student, yeah, so if I'm a ninth grade student and we transition, what that would look like for that ninth grade student, for example. So.
So right now on the current plan, if you are a ninth grade student, the question is, would you be graduating from Riverview East Academy? The answer would be no. Is that something that can be looked at and given consideration in terms of a transition? Yes.
Thank you. We also have a number of questions about Riverview students, how it's a school of choice now. That's why the heat map is the way it is. And what that will look like in the future once that transition, if this moves forward, once that transition to Spencer Center, what does that look like for Riverview students after that transition? So.
Yeah, that's a great question. So, all of our high schools are schools of choice, with the exception of a few where there are either an audition or a test in or the need for a Montessori background. But the majority of all of the other high schools are schools of choice. So, I may not be understanding the question or what someone really wants to ask, but all of our high schools, minus the ones with the testing component, audition background, or Montessori, are schools of choice.
No, I think that's great. I think that's that covers it, that they won't change because we're already schools of choice. So, will the LSDMC meeting be open to everyone? I'm guessing we're referring to the schools who are transitioning.
All of our LSCMC meetings are open, except in the case of conversation around the selection of a principal.
Why is the district redrawing the enrollment lines? West over east enrollment, east and west, et cetera. So.
Yeah, that's a fantastic question. That is a part of this work as well, looking at those lines and those boundaries, again, which will be reviewed over the course of 3 years starting this school year. And so we are looking at those lines.
We still have a number of questions about transportation. One being, will Spencer students still receive transportation if they move over to Riverview? And talking about, I think in general, and you've covered this. I don't want to bombard you with it again. How this will change transportation, or how we're looking to change transportation with the district lines and with the schools that are shifting.
Absolutely. Great question. Spencer Center students will receive transportation. And I believe that when the lines are reviewed, and this work has started long before Shauna Murphy, this has been work that the board has discussed over many, many years. But there will be a cost savings in transportation, which is one of the reasons why we need to look at the boundary lines.
Thank you very much, Superintendent. We have a question about what if students struggle with large school settings and are more comfortable with the smaller school settings?
Large school settings.
I'm guessing might be from Spencer or the Odell Owens, or moving into a bigger space. So
Sure.
I'm guessing and inferring
Sure.
here.
Yeah, I believe there are ample supports in buildings for transitioning kids. I believe that our staff will be just fine in working with those families. And if there are any concerns, we certainly can put pieces in place. And we'll put pieces in place to help the students transition properly.
Superintendent, we've got a couple of questions about refurbishing and redoing other buildings or properties that we seem to have. That seems to be a common theme as well.
Okay.
And of course, there's questions from people of why don't we redo those buildings and move some of these programs to those buildings instead of, my guess is probably Riverview. So.
I think I would need to know in particular what building, what program. As I mentioned, there are multiple schools, the entire district being looked at. And so I think I would need to specifically answer that question. I could maybe tell you where in the timeline that conversation might fit, might be a better response.
Great. One of the building suggestions was Linwood Academy building. That was one suggestion that was mentioned.
I don't know that Cincinnati Public Schools owns Linwood Academy at this time. I will double check on that though.
We continue are still getting some topics, so I want to honor this topic. It's about staff transition and moving staff around to different buildings and kind of how that works. Will people lose their jobs, for example? Will they have to find new jobs? Can we address that a little bit of how that works?
The teachers at Riverview East Academy will absolutely not lose their job. Is that the question, Rob? I think That's the question.
Yeah, I think it's, I think just transitioning, I think any of the programs from one to another, what
Any of the
happens to the
programs,
teacher?
there is no plan for a teacher to not have employment at this time based on this proposal.
We also have a question about Riverview. Is there concern about the dropout rate at Riverview if the school is closed, for example?
You know, the graduation rate is a concern for all of our high schools. We are working really hard to ensure kids are in school and that our graduation rate continues to grow. That would be a concern I would have for each and every one of our students.
So our next question is Mount Washington and our K-6 group. We've got a couple questions about how that transition works, and maybe talk a little bit about how the students will transition if they don't want to go to Mount Washington, or if they go to it. If the original one of the original questions was, will Mount Washington turn people away?
Mount Washington will not turn people away. I'm sorry, Rob.
No, it's okay. And so just kind of cover that whole topic if you don't mind.
All righty. Mount Washington will not turn students away. And at the same time, if there is a student who there's another school that they're interested in and there's space available, we can help facilitate that as well, if that is the student, the family's interest.
I think we've covered the breadth of the major topics. Like I said, we do have probably over 80 questions. And we really do appreciate everyone, you know, jumping in and participating. Will homeschool, I'm going to switch transition over here. Will homeschool be offered to students who cannot attend these other schools around the city?
Homeschool is a possibility. If there is an interest there, you can complete a homeschool application. If you need assistance with that, you can call the district and we can support you in that process.
Fantastic. And Superintendent, is there anything else you want to share moving forward? We will take time to process these questions. We will try to address some of them on the webpage when we put the PowerPoint out and work through them. And we really appreciate it. It's given us a lot of thought. Like I said, there's over 80 questions. We tried to grab the themes. We did not ask every individual question because there were so many. We really appreciate it. Yeah, and we will have another session again Monday at 5 o'clock for people who want to join, and hopefully we'll be able to use some of these questions to work on that space as well when we come back. Is there anything else you want to share, Superintendent, before we begin the work closing out?
The only thing I want to share is I appreciate every voice that has come to the table at this meeting. It's critically important to our school district, and we look forward to ongoing conversation. Thank you.
Superintendent, we really appreciate you taking the time to do this. And we really appreciate everyone's time for coming today. And again, you can join us again on Monday at 5 p.m. We are going live to Facebook. We'll also have the same link that you used here to be able to access it again. We will work on that page so that way we can share that in the future with the presentations, and more information. And we will post this video on that page as well. Thank you very much to Superintendent Murphy. We greatly appreciate you, and thank you everyone for chiming in today. Now we're going to go back, and we're going to put the we do have a survey we're asking for everyone to fill out. We've shared that in the chat, and we are going to put that on the screen here for you as well. And you see that now. We ask that you take that survey for us. We're going to keep the presentation or the live stream running for the next 4 minutes with this screen up for you, so that way you can take the survey. We put it in the Facebook chat, and I'm going to drop it in the chat one more time for you in the main chat. And we appreciate your participation as we as a district work through this process. So thank you so much. Everyone, have a wonderful night.